right, I think we are rolling here on Facebook Live. I'm gonna go ahead and share this video on my own page at Simone Cuccurullo TV. If you don't follow me already, please feel free to share this video, comment, like it, and you know, put it on your profile. Have all your friends see it and chime in. So we are actually talking about something that is very pertinent to the situation, for lack of a better phrase, with social media. And here to help join me on the topic is Jan Terry. She is a local author from Naples. Jan, thank you so much for being here with us today.
Thank you for having me.
So I'm going to make sure that we get this video out so that everyone can see it. But one of the things that I want to have you start with a little bit is telling us about yourself and your series of books and how you kind of got into these topics that are so important in this day and age.
Well, I have a master's degree in sociology and spent my life in marketing and advertising field. But I decided once I retired to some extent to come down to Florida. I'm a widow, and so that enticed me to come to Florida. And what I did was I went back to school, got certified as a life coach, and I'm writing a series of books, self-help books that should help people through their lives. And one of them is loneliness. Another one is online dating. And well, I'll be into my third book very soon.
It's kind of ironic because our part one of our series in the Loneliness Epidemic with Florida Weekly aired last week, and your publisher happened to see it and reached out via Facebook, speaking of social media. And it's kind of ironic timing because you're getting ready for this book to hit the stands. We're doing this piece with Florida Weekly. This is clearly a very prevalent problem in our society. Talk to me about just the reoccurrence of loneliness over the past few years.
Well, with the, I guess you could say, the onslaught of the internet, people are going inward more and more. Also, there's a huge stress factor in society. Divorces, the average divorce, well, the average marriage only lasts 7 years. And people are losing their jobs, can't make ends meet. And so consequently, they're getting lonely and they're turning inward for comfort. And that's why loneliness is on the uprise.
One of the questions that we got, and feel free if you're watching this to please leave a comment if you have a question, but what demographic does loneliness target? And the answer may surprise you.
Well, loneliness goes across every target audience. It skews probably to the older as well as to what I define as the millennials, because they are the ones that are having more trouble trying to purchase a home, trying to make ends meet. They can't seem to do that. But there is also an older set where people have lost their loved one, whatever it may be, and they're turning inward, as I said. They're in a survival mode, and consequently, loneliness sets in. Mm-hmm. Now, what my book does is it transforms you into from loneliness to being alone. And it is okay to be alone. It is okay to be sad at the beginning of this. But you need to come out of your shell and take it very, very slowly so that you can be by yourself, but interact with family, interact with your friends, go out periodically, do the things that you would like to do, which you are not doing right now.
So we don't have a copy of your book, Loneliness vs. Being Alone, just yet. It's still getting printed, but we do have copies of some of Jan's other book called Online Dating. So if you're interested in that, definitely take a look. They're affordable, only $10, you said, and it goes hand in hand with what we've been talking about in our series. It's interesting that you bring up the millennial population, because coming up tonight on ABC7 News at 7, we talk to a millennial who suffers from loneliness. She's a student. She goes to FGCU. Seemingly has everything going for her in life, but yet she was overwhelmed with this feeling of being lonely, and it's sad to see.
It's tough because there's you need an interaction with people, and people, to some extent, don't know how to do that. Mm-hmm. And the more they separate themselves from society or from their friends or family, the worse it gets. So you have to start and you have to change. And that's difficult. Change is difficult. It's fearful, you know, fear of the unknown. It's scary out there to try to change. And some people find it unbelievably hard. But there are things in my book that help you through that process of changing, integrating things into your life, into your home, into what you do on a daily basis. And that will get you out there and eliminate the loneliness and have you be alone. And I can't stress enough being alone is okay. It is great. And more people are. More and more people can't afford to get married. They can't afford a home, so they live by themselves.
Mm-hmm. One of the interesting topics, just as we head into the holiday season, I wanted to ask you, how can we help our family members who may feel alone during the holidays, that this could be magnified in a time when you're supposed to be cheery and happy in this time of year?
It's very difficult. What you need to do is try to invite people to your home, share your life with them, share the holiday with them. If they don't want to come, don't press it. Eventually, at some point in time, they will come out and do it. But holidays are a very, very difficult time. You need to get on the other side of the holidays. Mm-hmm. And if you're not invited anymore, then just be alone, be by yourself, but get out there right after the holidays. It's a difficult situation. Thanksgiving is coming up, mm-hmm. and everyone is having a real problem with that also, mm-hmm. because it's a family thing. But I can't stress that you should enough that you should get a buddy. Find someone that shares, to some extent, understands what you're going through. Now, if there's people out there that say, no, I don't think I'm going to do that, then that's fine. They don't want to take on the responsibility of helping you, and that's fully okay. But find someone that you can talk to, that you can share all of this, and that you can release, and that will really help you move forward.
So coming up tonight on ABC7 News at 7, we are going to be talking to the student who suffered from loneliness, and she's going to share her ways that she kind of got herself out of the funk that she was feeling. We're also going to have another piece in part 3 that airs tomorrow at 7, talking with experts in the area about how we can combat loneliness as a society, and hopefully in a few years from now, we can see this on the decline instead of becoming more and more popular. Thank you so much for being here with us. We really appreciate it. If you have any questions for Jan or for myself, just feel free to comment, share this video, write in, and be sure to tune in to ABC7 News at 7. Thank you, everyone. Have a good night.